Hey everyone, it's the interview queen Alicia Atout here, and it is my absolute pleasure to welcome you all to my interview with Inar from Wardruna. Hello.
Hello. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for joining me. How are you doing, and how are things holding up on your side of the world?
Yeah, I'm doing good. It's a busy time, and of course, exciting to release an album. It's a crazy world these days, Norway is no exception. Let's put it like that.
Well, this pandemic has definitely given people a lot of downtime to focus on the important things, since we can't really travel or explore as much as the pre-COVID days. So how has some of that downtime for you been spent? Have you kind of been consumed just putting this new record together?
Well, actually, the album was supposed to be released in June, but we had, due to the pandemic, we had to postpone it until now. But that, of course, if you say downtime, but it's actually been really
busy.
Hectic. I've been working a lot, of course, with the soundtrack for Assassin's Creed Valhalla as well, along with this. So I guess the pandemic allowed me to do that in a slightly more healthy way, being able to focus more fully on that in this period. And of course, it's been good to spend more time with the family and such. So I think it's important to maintain some sort of constructive focus in all of this. And as you say, we're not allowed to travel as much, but there are many things we can do and travel within instead. I think there are bound to be some positive sides to what has happened to this global pause as well.
I feel like at this point it's been going on for so long. We're soon going to be coming up on a year's time. You almost have to make positive light of it. Otherwise, you're just going to live every single day looking at the negative and in misery. So you have to.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, since we had briefly mentioned travel, I discovered that when you tour, you actually pack a lot of skulls and bones and horns. So what is it like for you going through customs, and what are some of the reactions you actually end up getting from people?
Actually, there hasn't been a lot of reaction to it. Of course, it's terrifying to send these instruments with airplane, because we all know how our luggage tends to be treated.
Right.
So it is sort of with a high pulse we send them away. There have been some strange looks and that kind of thing, but more like positive, curious in a curious way, and they're asking what it is, and as soon as you mention the word Viking to people, they get all excited. So it's been a positive thing.
It's different, and it definitely would spruce their day up, I'd assume, from seeing all the normal things in there. So
yeah, exactly.
Well, of course, you mentioned prior the upcoming record release. It's super exciting. It is just shaping up to be absolutely stunning. You've shared a few songs off of it, one in specific being Song of the Spirit Weaver. So do you still happen to get anxious or impatient prior to releasing a record, especially since it was supposed to be out mid last year?
Yeah. More excited than anxious, because I'm you know, I would never have put it out there if I wasn't truly happy with it myself. So I guess that's the most important thing. But of course, it's always it's always a special feeling to sort of put yourself out there, because that's what you're doing when you're releasing a piece of art into the world. Then it lives its own life, and it's your head on that, your head on the block, basically. So of course that's a special feeling, but I'm getting more and more used to it, and Well, so far people have been very kind to us, thankfully.
That's fantastic. I mean, it does come to the album's title, and I'm going to do my best Canadian attempt at this, but Keetrafen, is that somewhat?
Yeah. It's not so bad. Yeah.
I'll take not so bad.
Yeah. Kvitrap. Yeah.
Kvitrap. Okay. Yep. Well, the album's title does translate to White Raven, which you've associated with as your artist name. So why do you feel it just suits you so perfectly? And it's almost in essence something that you've taken on to yourself.
Well, first of all, I have to say that the album is not named after me, even though it's more kind of inspired by the same thing that inspired me to take that name in the first place. I've kind of always had a somewhat profound and felt a deep connection to the Raven. And of course, they are an animal that is very much it's very central in the Nordic tradition as well as being this sort of messenger from beyond and sort of seen as the animal embodiment of the human mind and memory So just on its own, it has a great symbolic value, and adding the tradition of these sacred white animals that we see in cultures all over the planet, in several Native American myths, you have them, you have the white animal, elephants or lions or reindeer for the Sami, and yeah, it's almost like a global phenomenon, these legendary or mythical white animals, spirit animals in a way, and they are very often connected to a prophecy they bring something new. They bring about some form of change or an enlightenment or something, it felt like the right time to let loose the White Raven in a way. So it is, I guess, the title. It has a strong element of, well, it contains a strong symbolic value and I guess contain some form of hope. The attempt to sow that seed of the White Raven, in a way.
That's such a beautiful representation and meaning behind a nickname, especially being from over here in North America. So many nicknames just come from the most ridiculous or goofy moments from when we were younger. So the fact that there's so much passion and meaning behind that, that's a really lovely thing to have.
Yeah, well, thank you.
Absolutely. Well, your vocals on these songs, ever since the beginning of the band, they truly just soar, and you have such a unique voice. So when did you actually realize that you had something different and you realized, I want to share this?
Well, I'm originally a drummer, but of course, I've always enjoyed singing. But I think you can tell on the first albums and even the first period where we did our first concert, that it's a more shy person there who, well, I don't think I had found my voice yet or was totally comfortable with that. That's something that I grew into, and at some point I started to do a lot of lectures and solo performances where I did like fully acoustic versions of these songs, just with a string instrument or something like that, and my voice. And I think when I started to do that, I kind of found my voice, because I had to do it in a different way connect to the songs in a totally different way. And I think that was a great help for me. Basically. And now I can't live without singing. it's my go-to drug, I would say, and medicine.
I feel like there are so many different elements to your music. And when I listen to it, there is such a sense of wonder between the vocals, the use of the old age or age old Nordic instruments. I mean, it really just kind of transports you somewhere else in a really cool way. So how important has it always been for you to kind of carry out those myths, sounds, traditions, or inspirations into your music and just represent full on where you're from?
Well, I guess the idea of doing this is kind of born out of the absence of anyone else doing it, because I could sort of see it or hear it, and I really wanted someone. I wanted there to be some music that interpreted these traditions and myths and stories on their own premises, rather than just borrowing small elements here and there. Yeah, I guess that was the start of it. I wanted to create music representing these traditions that was, yeah, relevant to the content, and record in relevant places, relevant time of year, use relevant language, etc. Anything I could do to bring me as close as possible to what it, yeah, to the subject, given subject I'm working with. So there's been of course it's very kind of a time consuming complicated way to do things, but because, yeah, to a certain degree, you can almost say that it's the stories that is the composer, and I am just the instrument. It's also truly fulfilling to do it. And I believe that there are so many things from the past that that still carry the same relevance that it used to do thousands of years ago. It's things that are born out of the very same surroundings that we live in. And even though my music is sort of wrapped in a Nordic or Norse kind of wrapping, the content is in many ways global and universal, can speak to, when you go far enough back in time, you see how strikingly similar a lot of our ways are.
Absolutely. I mean, the last thing that I did want to ask you about, since we are talking about stories and just things that you can kind of watch and be captured by, on my site, I not only interview musicians like yourself, but also wrestlers. And so much of that is completely story-based, very different, but very story-driven. So for you, if you were to have a in-ring wrestling persona or gimmick, what do you think that would be for you?
Oh, that's a difficult question, but also quite fun. No, it would have to be the White Raven, of course.
Oh, so fitting.
Yeah.
Well, I really do want to say thank you so much for taking the time. I know myself and fans all around the globe are very highly anticipating this upcoming record release. So just thank you so much for hopping on here today.
Thank you so much for having me.
Absolutely. Everyone watching, this has been Wardruna. Be sure to stay tuned for their upcoming album release and check out aliciatout.com for more exclusive interviews and features. Bye, everyone.